Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all to my channel. Today we are going to learn an English chapter of class 10. And the name of the chapter is A Wrong Man in Worker's Paradise, written by Rabindranath Tagore. But before going to the chapter, students, if you are viewing my channel for the first time, do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get the notification of my upcoming videos. And if you like the video, please hit the like button too. Now about the author, Rabindranath Tagore was also known as Bhanu Singha Thakur. Actually, it was his pen name, and he was also known by many sobriquets. Means his many nicknames were there, like Gurudev, Kabi Guru, Viswa Kabi. And he was also a Bengali poet, writer, music composer, and a painter from the Indian subcontinent. And he has achieved many awards also for this. And this chapter which we are learning today is also was also written in Bengali language, and later it was translated. So let us see what do we have to learn in this chapter. Actually, here the writer, the author, is trying to give us the information, a fictitious story about the man who is very lazy, and he's gone to a wrong place. Means the person who is useless is not doing any work in the world, but he is getting a place somehow in the paradise, in the workers' paradise. So it is the wrong place where he has been gone, where he has been sent. So this lesson also gives you some message, and the message is that you have to be always in the correct place. Like you have to match your place and you have to be there. Like if you are a person of some quality, you have to be in that kind of group. If you are in another group totally where you are not interested and where you do not work, so it will not match and you will not be accepted by that kind of society or the group. So that is how the story goes on. Come on now, let's see the story. The man had never believed in mere utility. The man did not believe in the useful work, and he used to always do all the useless works and the mad whims, the mad activities he used to do. He just used to collect the small pieces of the sculpture of men, women, castles. He used to make it. He used to make earthen pots and the things which are made out of clays, and he used to just paint the shells. And this is how he just wasted all of his time in the earth. And the people used to laugh at him. At times he used to just think that I will keep away from these activities. But these activities and the thoughts did not get out of his mind. It anyhow lingered in his mind here and there. So it is as if some boys, they seldom ply their books and yet pass the test. Means some boys, they do not touch their books at all. But even they somehow they pass the test. So it is just the fate which gives them the partnership, or which helps them to get out of the test without touching the books. So in the similar manner here, it happened with this man. He spent his life in the earth uselessly doing useless works, and yet after his death, he got the place in the heaven above. He got the gates open in the heaven, and he got a place there. But moving fingers writes him even in heaven. This phrase means that even the fate works in the heaven too. So it came here that it came to pass that the angel messenger who took charge of the man made a mistake and found him a place in workers' paradise. And he also further adds that the angel messenger who had come to take this man to take away from the earth and may give him a place wherever he had to be, he was suited according to his deeds. He had made a mistake. He did not find him a good proper place, and he just made him to go in the workers' paradise, which was opposite to this person's nature and quality. So it was by mistake of angel messenger that this person had gone in the wrong place. Now in this paradise, you find everything except leisure. You had all the time, you had everything there, but there was no leisure, no free time, nothing to do with the useless things here. And here men always they used to say that we haven't a moment to spare. Means they were so busy doing their works that they did not have in a single moment or a time to talk or whisper among each other, nor do any other extra things or for themselves. And time was so precious in this world, in this workers' paradise. And we have our hands full. The works were just waiting, and they did not have a single minute to stop and do something else which was not useful. So this is how it was happening in this world. But this newcomer, how he passed the life in the earth in the same way he was doing there. He was just sitting and seeing in the workers' paradise. He moved here and there absent-mindedly, and he just jostled the hurrying men. Jostled means just dashed it. Because they were hurrying, going for their work, they did not notice this man. And this man usually very lazily, he used to move here and there, and he just jostled and dashed each and everyone. And he always used to lay down in the green meadows, in the green gardens, and just rested and just saw the flowing streams and the work which was done by the farmers, busy farmers. They used to do the work, but this person, he used to just sit and see them. Never used to do any work. There, even a bustling girl went every day to her work. She used to go to the silent torrent. The torrent is nothing but the stream, the water body. And she used to fill the pitchers. Pitchers is nothing but a water pot to fill the water, a pot to fill the water. She used to carry this pitcher to the silent torrent every day, and she used to go. The girl's movement on the road was like a rapid movement. She never wasted a time waiting or just standing or moving in a slow manner. It was like as if a string of a guitar is moved by a skilled musician. In the same way, this girl's rapid movement was moving, going ahead. And her hair was carelessly done. She never had time to do any set her hairs, and she had many inquisitive whips, means many questions in her mind and to be asked, but there was no time to ask all those things. And this idler was just standing by the stream and used to see this girl every day when she used to go here and there and fill the pot. And even this girl, she used to see this lonely beggar, and she was feeling pity on this person that everyone is so busy, and why this person is not having any work? Why is this lying out without any work? And she was filled with pity after seeing this beggar for so many days. Then she came to him. She asked with concern, "You have no work in hand, have you?" The man sighed and he said, "Work? I have no mo not a moment to spare for work." So this girl, because of pity, she comes and asks that person, that man, that, "Don't you have any work to do?" So this man is saying, "Work? I don't have a moment to spare for work." That means he's busy in doing useless things, that he don't have work to do, don't have time to do a work. So he replied like this. Then the girl did not understand his words, and she just went away from there. "I shall spare some work for you to do if you like." So she just added on the line, "If you want some work, I'll give you from my side some work. You can do that. My work you can be doing." And then just she moved it from there. So the man replied, girl of the silent torrent, that "I have been waiting to take some work from your hands." That means that boy, man was saying, "I was waiting for you itself, that you will come and give me some work." So she said, "What kind of work would you like?" Then he answered, "Give me one of your pitchers, the pot which you are having, water pot." Then she has a pitcher. "You want to draw water from a torrent," she asked. "What will you do with the pitcher? You will fill the water?" He said, "No, I will not fill the water, but I should draw pictures on your pitcher. Means I may draw some drawings on your pitcher, on your pot." The girl was annoyed. She became angry. "Pictures indeed, I have no time to waste." She just shouted that, "I don't have any time to waste on you, and I'm going." She went away from there. But how could a busy person get the better of one who had nothing to do? Every day they met, and every day he said to her. And then she was just thinking, every day she used to go to her work, and this man, he used to meet every day, and he used to every day ask from the girl to give her one of her pictures so that he can do the work. At last she yielded, she shouted, and she gave it to him, one of her pictures. Then the man started painting. He drew many lines, he put the colors, and then when it was completed, he gave back to the girl. And she started seeing from the every side, and her eyes puzzled because she had never seen those things before. Then she asked him, "What do they mean, all those lines and colors? What is the purpose? Like, without purpose, nothing was done in that paradise." So she was asking, "What is the reason behind it? What is its purpose?" The man laughed. He said, "Nothing. There is no purpose. There may be no meaning and serve no purpose, but it's just an art." He just said like this. The girl went away with a big confusion in her eyes, and in her mind. Then she went home, she put the light, she turned around and around and scanned the painting from all the angles, but she did not get what is the purpose behind this. Then again at night, she couldn't sleep. Again, she got out of bed. Again, she lighted the lamp and again, she scanned everything. It means she saw the pot from every side, every angle, again in the silence. Then for the first time in her life, she said she had seen something without meaning, which did not have any purpose at all. Because before that, everything they did, it was for some purpose, it had some meaning. And this was for the first time she had seen. Then when she set out for the torrent the next day, her hurrying feet were a little less hurried than before. Now even she started getting into this useless work. Means the wood. Before she was never not having a time or a moment to waste or lower her feet or her walk a moment. But now her feet, her walking style had been slown. For a new sense seemed to have awakened in her. Now new kind of thinking was in her mind, which has no meaning and no purpose at all. To do nothing. Means to do nothing. Now she saw the painter standing by the torrent and asked in confusion, "What do you want of me? Only some more work from your hands." So again that man was standing there. Again she asked him, "What do you want now from me?" Again he's saying, I want some more work from you." So again she asked, "What kind of work would you like to do now?" He asked, "Then give me your colored ribbon. I'll color it in a different colors. Let me color your ribbons for your hair." He answered like this. Then again she asked him, "For what will you color it?" Then he said, "Nothing. Ribbons were made bright with colors, and he made it with the colorful different colors, and he gave back to the girl." The busy girls work of the worker paradise had now started spending a lot of time in tying the colored ribbon to her hair and setting her hairs, which she did not do before because she did not have time. But now she started wasting the time in setting her hairs and putting the colored ribbon. Then the minutes slipped by unutilized, much work was left unfinished. And when she started doing all this work, setting her hairs, tying her ribbons, much of the work which was she was doing was left unfinished. Now everything started piling up. Now in Workers' Paradise, there was a new moment and a new thing going on, that the work was started to delay. They began to suffer to complete the work, and many persons who were active before, now they became idle. They started wasting their time in the useless things such as painting and sculptures. Even they followed these things. Now the elders became very anxious. They wanted to stop this. What is happening in this paradise now? And for that purpose a meeting was called, and all agreed that such a state of affairs had never happened in the history of Workers' Paradise. Now what is this happening here? Then the angel messenger hurried in. He bowed before the elders and he made a confession. This is that angel messenger who made a mistake of bringing this useless man to the Workers' Paradise. He confessed them in front of the elders that it is my mistake. I brought it by mistake this person to this paradise, and this is a wrong man into this paradise, he said. So it is all because of him this is happening, and everyone is delaying their work, and all sorts of situations are being created here. Then the man was summoned, means he was ordered to come in front of all the person the next day. Then as he came, the elders saw his dress, his appearance, the brushes, the paints, and they knew at once that he was not right sort of worker to be in that paradise. So they said that that person stiffly, the president of that group, that meeting, he said, "There is no place for the like of you. You must leave." Means there is no place for such person like you. So you may leave this paradise and go. The man sighed in relief and gathered up the brush and paint, because he was also feeling a unique kind of environment there. He sighed and he got relieved, and he just collected all his brushes and paints, all his belongings which he had, and he was just about to go from there when this girl of Silent Torrent started shouting and cried and asked the person to wait for a moment, and even she wanted to go along with him. Then again the elders started gasping and stalking and murmuring in surprise that never before had a thing like this happened in Workers' Paradise. Like, it never happened before like this. A thing that had no meaning and no purpose at all. What is the meaning in going along with that unknown person from here. It is all without any purpose, and this is happening for the first time. So they were still in the confusion, and the whole scenario of the paradise had changed because of this one wrong person. So this is what the lesson about. I hope you understood the moral, like if particular group is not suitable, it's not suiting your taste and your quality, you need not be there, because they'll have no value and respect for your presence there. So it's a very good lesson, which is giving a very important message to be applying in our lives. So I hope you understood the chapter, and thank you for watching my video. If you liked it, do not forget to hit the like button. Thank you.